Hey guys, James here from Devoted Gaming, and this is a walkthrough for Ni No Kuni, Wrath of the White Witch. Hey guys, welcome back to the walkthrough. In the last part, we lost Oliver's mom, and we met Mr. Drippy. And now we have to find something in the fireplace that will help us get to Drippy's world, which is a spellbook.
What could be hidden in a place like this?
A mighty spellbook!
Huh? A book? But it would burn in there.
Not this book. The wizard's companion laughs in the face of fire. Wouldn't be much of a spell book if it didn't, now would it?
Really?
Aha! Gotcha!
This is a spell book?
That there is the wizard's companion, the fount of all wizarding knowledge.
The wizard's companion.
So here's a tutorial about the Wizard Companion, which is basically a huge book full of tutorials and questions that are answered in here. I'm not gonna bother reading this out loud because it's tutorial stuff, but I have to write my name in this book. And the funny thing is they tell me I don't have to write Oliver, you can write whatever you want. It's kind of weird. But it's guess put your name, and I am Oliver, so I'm gonna put Oliver. Doesn't really make sense for me to put James. I spelled that right, right? Oh, yeah, this looks right.
Tidy. Right, magic in our way over to my world, is it? Now let's see.
What is it?
You got a wand somewhere by here? We can't go casting spells without a wand now, can we?
A wand? Why would we have a wand?
Oh, that's a pain. Ah, well, can't be helped. We'll just have to look for one outside.
Huh? We won't find one out there either.
Don't nitpick, crybaby Bunting.
Bunting? My name is Oliver. Oliver.
Ah, so the crybaby bit was right, at least was it.
Righto, time to find ourselves a magic wand. You mean there's one hidden somewhere around here, like the spellbook? Ah, you're having a laugh if you think I'm gonna make it that easy, man. What do you think I am, made of wizarding equipment? I can't do Drippy's accent. What accent is that anyway? Anybody know? So why don't you treat this as a warm-up, the Easter egg hunt before the wild goose chase, if you will. The huh? Okay, I guess. Okay, I'm lying. The thing it is, I never brought a wand with me. I mean, look at me. The prince of my lovability is my small stature, ain't it? I only just managed to carry that flippin' bookman. Any more and I've been crushed. So even fairies tell lies, huh? Of course they do. Us fairies are incorrigible liars. Anyway, no point crying over spilled milk. Let's find ourselves a substitute, shall we? A substitute? How can there be a substitute for a magic wand? Well, if you find something brown and sticky, like maybe a stick, we might just be able to muddle through. Brown and sticky. What are they trying to say here? I'll give you a hand. Follow me, Bunton. I'm sorry if I'm making your ears bleed. Because even though I said in the last video, if you want me to be not read the subtitles, I'm probably recording like this right after the first one, so it might not be up on my gaming channel yet, so I might not have read your comments saying shut up James, so. It might take a few episodes for me to realize that you guys don't want me to read the voices, because you know how I pre-record everything before I put it online and edit. It might take at least first 3 episodes for me to read your comments saying if you want me to read the subtitles or not when there's no voice acting. And it's teaching me about my bottomless bag. I like how in this game they call my bag the bottomless bag, You know how in video games, every time you have a backpack, it seems like your backpack can put so much stuff. Well, in this game, they call it the bottomless bag, which makes a lot of sense, because you can put a lot of stuff in it. I really like how they put said bottomless. So you gotta look for something, you know, brown and sticky. It's no use. There's nothing around here that looks like a wand.
You're not wrong, Bunting. Alright, we better split up, then board in the searchlight. I'll go and take another quick look around your house. You stay by here and head up outside to search, okay?
Okay. Okay, brown and sticky. Brown and sticky.
Oliver?
Huh? Oh, it's you. It's that mysterious girl again.
You're the little girl I met before, huh?
Mm-hmm. We met before.
So, how do you know who I am?
I'm really, really sorry, Oliver.
Huh?
Your mummy. I'm sorry. I couldn't save her.
Huh? I don't... Why would you be sorry for that?
I wanted to save her. I really did.
Huh? Hey, wait. Where are you... going? Hey, where did you go?
Ollie boy, why are you talking to thin air?
Mr. Drippy, she disappeared again.
Huh? Who did?
That strange girl. That's the second time she tried to talk to me.
What's that? A girl? Where? You're right about strange. I can't see her any flipping where.
Well, how could you? She disappeared into thin air.
Well, anyway, there's something I want to ask you.
There is? Sure, go ahead.
Do you mind it? You know, having a sidekick, like.
Huh? A sidekick? Who do you mean?
Crikey, that's cold. Who do you mean, he says? Why not stab me in the heart while you're at it? I mean me! I wanted to know if it was all right me joining you on your adventures. Or if you were maybe wanting to trade me in for a younger, prettier model. But it looks like I got my answer, huh? Well, so you know, if you don't have faith in people, you'll never see their true worth. And what's more?
Look at this.
Huh?
It was on the ground, right where that girl was standing.
Chuck it here, then. Top. Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle. It's a wand.
You mean it? A real wand?
Come over by here and take a look, man. It might seem like any old stick, but it's got all magic writing on it, see?
It does, huh? Wow. Is that how people write in your world?
The runes are all faded, so it might have lost a bit of power. But for our current purposes, it's a beauty.
Neato. What a stroke of luck.
Luckier than you know, Ollie boy. Dude, I never thought we'd actually find one.
Do you think maybe that girl brought it here for me?
So we got something brown
right,
and sticky.
Now we need...
Oops.
To cast Gateway, you need somewhere proper massive. You need space to give it oomph, see?
Do we really need that much oomph?
Yeah, what kind of question is that? Magic is special, innit? It's sacred, right? You have to cast spells in the best environment possible. You really are new to this, aren't you? This is beginner stuff we're talking about here.
Oh, sorry.
Now, take me somewhere with plenty of space. There's got to be somewhere around by here.
The town square, I guess.
So I guess we're off to the town square to cast the Gateway spell, which will lead us to Mr. Drippy's world. And that's where things can pick up in this game. This has been very slow.
Do you really think we should be doing this here?
No worries, man. Normal people can't see magic, see? Go on, Ollie boy. Cast Gateway.
Just one click. Mm-hmm.
Go on, boy back! Tiny! Told you, they didn't notice a thing. Yeah. Let's get a shunt in, crybaby Bunting.
For the last time, it's Oliver.
Hey, it's not bad work for a crybaby, this.
Oh.
Shall we?
Huh? Hey, wait for me! So this is your world.
Ah, home at last! But there's a tidy way to go yet.
Hey, Mr. Drippy, that was pretty neat just now, huh?
Oh, that herd of elk! Enjoy your first encounter with the majestic wildlife of our mysterious world, did you?
Uh-huh. Huh? Jeepers.
Oh, Nickers! Where did he spring from?
Ah! What do we do?
He's not like the big softies just now. He's itching for a fight. Proper savage.
Let's run away.
No, use that stick you got by there. Give him a whacking and send him packing. Look lively. He's making his move.
So we're introduced to battles. Now you're forced to use Oliver right now, and since I am level 1 and he only has one method of attack, which is to hit people with a stick, you can imagine how weak he is right now. But the purpose of Ni No Kuni isn't about using the characters themselves to fight, it's about using the monsters. So, you know, I don't really pay attention to, you only really pay much to too much attention to the tutorial about using Oliver too much. But even when you get your first monsters to control, Oliver's still kind of stronger than they are. Anyway, I'll get to that once I get my monsters to control. Well, they're called familiars in this game. And of course, sometimes when you hit them, they drop orbs. Green orbs give you health. Blue orbs give you MP, magic points. So, nice and simple. And of course, yes, you can give commands to your character, but your character can also move around. You can move your character around for battle. So it is turn-based, yes, but you can still move around the battlefield, which I do like. I hate having you control three dimensions in an RPG game, like an action RPG. I hate those sometimes. Like turn-based with a little bit of free run. That's a good balance, I would say. More experience points, and I did 2 damage to him.
Proper tidy! Nice one, Ollie, mate!
Jeepers, creepers!
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention. Our world is absolutely riddled with beasties. But keep that up and you'll have nothing to worry about. Right, let's get a move on, shall we?
Sure, Mr. Drippy. But where are we going?
Well, first off, we need to get you a wand.
But I already have a wand.
You're having a laugh, aren't you? That thing's about as magical as a flipping cabbage. You might just squeeze a gateway spell out of it. But you can forget about anything more than that. Honestly, I wish you'd think before you open your mouth.
Oh, sorry.
No, I told you Ding Dong Dell was just over by yonder, didn't I? Well, if we're very lucky, we might find a wand with a bit more oomph down by there.
So, are wands really so hard to find here?
Well, time was you couldn't move for the flipping things. But since Shaddaa showed up, magic's taken a real nosedive. He banned people from using it, see? Cursed anyone who tried to. He scared them all so much they gave it up.
So, he's pretty scary, huh?
Well, he turned me into a flipping doll, didn't he? Just saying his name's enough to make most folks brick it. Still, I'd rather be a doll than have him go poking round in my heart. No one wants to be broken-hearted.
Broken-hearted? Like, sad?
Worse than that. Much worse. It's when he steals a piece of a person's heart. Poor beggars don't know whether they're alive or dead. That's no way to live, man.
So that's why they're all so scared of him, huh? We can't let him go on doing this.
Well, it's not a matter of letting him, is it? It's not like people flipping enjoy it. That's why I brought you here, innit? You might just be able to stop him, see?
You really think I can?
Course you can! You are the pure-hearted one! And the legends say that the pure-hearted one will drive away the darkness. We'll teach you a few tasty spells and you'll be ready to face him in no time. Sound good to you?
Okay, I'll do it. I'll learn magic.
Of course you will, and that's why we need to find you a better wand.
All right, let's head for Ding Dong Dell.
Tidy.
And with that, we're on the overworld map now. Not many RPG games have an overworld these days, I find. Of course, teaching you about monster encounters, blah 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 blah, that you guys read on your own time. I might actually have to stop the video here because it's kind of running a bit long. I find that this game do have moments where they talk more than there's more action. So I'm gonna stop here. It's more tutorials Mr. Drippy's talking about, so I'm not bothering reading out loud like I would. We'll have to head to Ding Dong Dell next time. So thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.